I'm gonna get bigger. Getting ready to hatch. Look at her. She has not gotten off of that nest for 2 weeks. Isn't she being a good mama?
Oh my gosh, yeah.
Now, you guys, Butterscotch has two brand new babies in there. Listen, a three. Who's doing that? Oh, the goat is. Okay. You guys. Oh, little goatee. She has three brand new babies, and they need to be very, very quiet. She's very young. I think that might be why she's outside. Because do you think her babies need to be nursed?
Yeah.
Because they're mammals, right? And baby mammals need to have milk from their mama.
Mm. Yeah,
so she goes in there. I saw her in there this morning. But we can't go into this cage because we don't want to scare Buffy and we don't want to scare Butterscotch.
Hey, Butterscotch.
Oh, you guys, look, there's something I want to show you. Very interesting. Do you see some Butterscotch's fur?
Yeah.
Do you see?
Yeah,
that's
yeah.
One way. She's very little. It was hard to tell she had three babies in her tummy. But one way you can tell is
looking for some letters, because she loves carrots and she loves carrots and she loves carrots. And you're so sweet.
You guys, now you guys who were running over there. You didn't hear what I said about the rabbits. Would somebody please tell?
They have three babies.
You guys. All right, let's talk about some structures that have to do with the chickens. Remember that for all the plants that we were growing out in our garden, everything started from a seed. Have you heard the saying, which comes first, the chicken or the egg?
Yeah.
So, we don't know which comes first, but we need to talk about the eggs because all the chickens that we have came from eggs to begin with. Now, here is a diagram about the structure of the egg. Hope you can see that. Okay, so the incubation time we just talked about, the time that it takes for a chicken to develop inside a fertilized egg is 21 days, and we talked that the chicken's body temperature is 104. So in order for this egg to develop into a real chick, it needs to have, we have to control for the warmth, it has to stay 104, pretty much. And that's why the mother chicken stays on top of the eggs the whole time. And there has to be a certain amount of moisture, and actually the moisture comes from the mother chicken does have kind of a bare space that's down in the part where she'd be sitting on the chicken. So she does have a little bit of moisture that goes into the egg. And another thing that has to happen every day is the egg has to be turned. Edgar? Okay, let's pretend that Edgar's, put out your hand, baby. Let's pretend that Edgar's hand is a nest, okay? Now, let's pretend my hand is a chicken sitting on it. I'm going to fluff out my feathers to make sure this egg stays nice and warm. And then once in a while, with my little beak, I'm going to turn it like this. Because if I don't turn it, you know what happens? What? I think this happened to one of our baby chicks. Do you remember his foot was kind of crunched up? Remember Chinua when he was born? Why do you think his foot might have been kind of turned under? Because he didn't get turned enough. What do you think happens when Natasha doesn't get turned enough? Right, exactly. If they don't have the right temperature, if they don't get turned enough, and also if the little holes, the little pores that take the moisture in, if there's not enough moisture, if it gets way, way too dry, you're exactly right. It won't form correctly. And so the little chicken that we had that had been turned underfoot, it's probably that the egg didn't get turned enough, and when he was ready to hatch, he was on top of his own foot, and it kind of deformed it a little bit. So it's really important. So as a mother, I'm sitting down here, I'm all fluffed up, so it's warm. I'm sweating a little bit so he stays moist, and then I'm going to turn it like this. And that's what Buffy does with her eggs. She stands up, and she like turns them once in a while. Okay, now, what's happening inside of this egg, okay? Inside this egg, okay, all right. There is a fertilized egg right in the very center. There's something that's called an embryo. Remember I said the seed, there was a little embryo? Remember the secret of the seed? We have the seed coat. We have the food that the seed eats, the starch, and then you have a little embryo. The egg has a very similar structure. Here's its coat, the white coat. Do you guys remember why the coat is white?
Keeps them warm.
And it's hard, right? Listen, like this. Same color as my teeth. Clink, clink. Because of calcium, you're right. It has a hard coat of calcium. Yes, sweetheart. Oh, brown eggs, same thing. They're made out of calcium, but there's a different kind of pigment. Pigment is color that comes from the mother's body. But it's all made out of the same thing. That's a very good question. Now, Natasha has this wonderful red hair. Let's see. And Essence has this wonderful blonde hair. And Edgar has this lovely, yours is almost black. It's really a good color. Yours is brown, mine's brown. But all of our hair is made out of the same thing, but it has a different amount of pigment in it. So the pigment doesn't change the structure of the egg. That's a really good question. It's still calcium. The color is just a little bit different. Okay, it's still hard, it still protects the egg. And it's the outer shell. Okay, inside this shell, there's a whole other layer. And it's called the same thing. Remember that seed I broke up, the one that we floated? It had that paper stuff? What was that called?
Membrane.
Membrane, exactly. Inside this egg, there's a layer of a membrane, and it does the same thing that the membrane did in that seed, which is what? It's another coat, and it protects it. Yeah, right, exactly. So let's say the outside of the shell gets dirty, and some dirt gets in there through those little pores. Still, this membrane inside is going to protect the little embryo growing in the middle. Now, after you get the shell, after you get the membrane, oh, and this shell looks like it's hard, right? It is hard. It looks like it's totally solid, but there are little holes. There are little pores in there. This shell actually breathes. So if this was going to be developing into a chick, would I put my grubby hands on it?
No.
My grubby hands are all oily. They could clog up these little holes so there couldn't be air. Would I do that? No. And because that's another thing you were saying, Natasha, the kid about the chicks not developing correctly. If they don't have enough air going through that membrane, going through the shell, and then it's porous. And then this is a semi-permeable membrane. So air can go in, but larger things like germs or so forth, things that wouldn't be good for the chicks, they don't go in because they're too big. Because the pores are small. It's semi-permeous. That means semi-permeable. That means some things can go in, but not other things. Things that are good, like oxygen, can go in. They're small molecules. But larger ones, like some kind of bacteria, they can't go through.
So
isn't that neat?
If it doesn't like do what it's supposed to do, it'll get deformed?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And this membrane protects it from that happening. So the inside part, the same as with your seed. Remember you had that starch stuff that the seed eats? So it's a little lunch underneath its arms there. Now, this little egg also carries its lunch bags with it too. And whenever you guys, have you broken up an egg? So what's this part here, the center part called?
Yolk.
The very center, the yellow part is the yolk. Right, that is the part. Who knows what this white stuff's called? It starts with A.
Albumin.
All right, essence, albumin. Whoa, good word. Albumin. This is like a white, like a viscous, kind of like a, okay, it's like a snotty kind of thing. Or a mucousy or a spitty kind of a thing. It's all mucousy and sticky, but actually this also protects the egg because it's like You know when a baby's growing in its mom's tummy, when it's in your mom's tummy, there's water all around in the little sac that you're in, so that you're totally protected by this water. This does the same thing. It's used as food, but it protects the baby egg inside. Now, there's one last thing I want you guys to look at. See these little things? They look like little cords. They have a neat name. Anybody know what that is? Okay, let's see. Chalice. You are right. They are called chalice. They're kind of like little cords, like little bungee cords. Little bungee cords. And they actually, they hold the yolk in place. Isn't that neat? Yeah. You have seen a chalice? You want to see a real one? Okay. You guys know what these structures are in this picture. I'm going to see if you can really, really identify them if I break this little egg that Edgar is holding. Okay, now this one is not a fertile egg, so Natasha's worried if she's going to kill a little baby chick. No, this is not a fertile egg.
It's from the store.
This one's from the store. Okay, now watch you guys. Okay.
Why are baby chicken?
Natasha, the protector of nature, she would not let me do it. I love you. Okay, now, here we go. I'm going to crack the shell. One. I hope I can crack the shell. One, two, here it goes. Now watch. You need to come closer. Whoa, look at that. Oh, there's a chalice. Look, there's two on each side. Now, look at this. Here's the shell. I'm going to show you guys there really is a membrane in here. Look at this.
Nice.
Look at that membrane. It's just like paper. Look at that. It does. You want to feel it? Okay, you guys, now on the inside, there's the part that's from the, you know, that still feels a little like the egg. On the outside, it's dry, just like paper. Feel it. Isn't that neat? It does. Feel that.
Really wet.
Want to feel that? On the outside, it's dry. Part that's toward the shell is dry. Isn't that neat? Feel that. I love that. Is that neat?
Like, Miss Heather, if it's clear right there for right now, and well, how does it turn white when you cook?
That is a very good question. Okay, the albumin does turn white when it's cooked. The reason why it turns white is because it's made out of a type of protein, and when the protein gets heated up, it changes its structure so it becomes hard instead of liquid. And as it becomes hard, the molecules, like they get they have a structure together that makes them firm, and it changes color also. Is that neat? That's a neat question. It's because of the protein that this albumin is made out of. Now, okay, we see this little chalice right there. I'm going to see if I can pull that chalice off. Okay? Let's see if I can cut it off, okay? I hope I got it. You little chalice. It's just like a bungee cord. It is so neat. Mm-hmm. Oh, look at this. Look. Okay. I got chalice. It does. I think you're right.
It's like so like a goo. Squishy goo.
I should say I got it from my nuts. That's really gross. Now, I'm sorry, the teachers are not going to like that. Okay, all right. Isn't that neat though? Okay, now there's, well, now you saw our chalice, okay? All right, I want to get these things all in a row here. Okay, now let me see. Now we have, there it is. There we go. Membrane, chalice. Now, this part, I want you guys to feel this part right here. Okay, can you see that? Okay. All right, then go ahead and wipe your hand off. Wipe your hand off. There's a part on the outside that's a little bit thicker Than the part that's on the inside?
Well, like when you make scrambled.
Yeah, isn't that neat? See, it's separating. Yeah,
it's really cool when you make scrambled eggs because the white and this, it sort of makes like a sun color.
Yeah, it does. It does. Yeah, when you mix it all up, you're exactly right. Now, inside this yolk, okay, there's another kind of a little membrane that holds the yolk into the space here. Now, if there were a little baby chicken there, if I would, now whenever I break that membrane, what's going to happen to the yolk, you guys? What do you think? It will spread out. Let's try it. Okay, let's. Ah, there it goes, guys. I broke the little membrane. Look, there it goes. See the it's, yep, there it goes. It's going out. All right. Now, if there were a little embryo right there, you would see kind of like a little red spot. And that's what would develop totally into the chip.
So it's sort of like a gusher, like it sort of has a little squishy thing, and then when you break it, like gooey stuff comes out.
Exactly. And the membrane holds it in place. Now, you guys are my scientists, right? Scientists don't believe what somebody says. You have to try it out for yourself, okay? I have a scientific question that I want to give you. And I want you to observe. Think about the scientific question. Let's make a hypothesis. A hypothesis means I'm going to ask you guys a question. And you're going to say, is this true or not? If I do this, will this happen? Okay? Now, and then we have to test our hypotheses. Let's test our question. And then we're going to find out if the question is true or not. This is the scientific method we're going to be doing. Okay, I have a question for you guys. Now, you saw me break the shell, right? You saw what happened to this egg all over here. Do you think it would be possible for me to take an egg? If I would take this egg and drop it, could I bounce this egg?
No.
What would happen?
It would just crack.
Here's my scientific question. Would it ever be possible to, without cooking it, I mean, you know, if you could cook it, maybe it'd be hard, then this egg, just like this, nice and raw in the middle, could I take an egg and bounce it?
Yes.
You say no, you say yes. Let's test it out. Okay, all right, let's test it out. Okay, now, each one of you, I'm going to give each one of you a cup, okay? Now, you know what you can do? You can make some money from your parents. Or you can make some money from your teachers. You can say, I have a question for you. Let's give our teachers one also. You can say, I have a question for you. You can say, I will just bet you that if I could drop an egg, it would bounce. And they'll say, a raw egg. They'll say, no, no, no. You say, okay, well, how much money will you give me?
I think maybe you can do it in a cup.
$20? Not bad.
I think maybe you can do it in a cup. It's not on a plate because you just drop it, and maybe it'll be a flat surface because the cup surface has not.
Now look what she's doing. She's using her intelligent mind, and she's forming a hypothesis She's forming a potential explanation about how she could do this. Okay.
Because the cup has a little flat.
The cup could hold it, she thinks. Could hold the structure of the egg. That's a possibility. Okay. Now, all right. Essence still says yes, you can do it. All right. And Natasha says yes. Okay. Now, listen to this sound here. This calcium. Okay? I'm gonna do an experiment here. Who knows what this is, you guys?
Vinegar,
right? Okay. Vinegar is a type of acid and it makes it taste. Okay, I'm gonna let you guys smell this.
I'm not smelling. I hate the smell.
I like it when you do taste it if you want.
No.
Yeah. You're really brave. Now you know Miss Heather does this stuff. Okay, look.
Heather will taste
it. If you're really, you can. I got the adventurous spirit there. She's going to try it. Okay, pass it over here, sweetie. Your cup a little bit. Okay. And then put it down in a really flat place so it's not going to touch.
Okay.
Yes, sweetheart. Don't you guys like salad in a dressing?
Yeah.
Sometimes it's, ooh, she thought it's too sour.
Okay.
Way too sour.
Do you like it?
I think that's a no vote.
A definite no.
Okay. Let me see. Now let me put a little bit more. Let me give you a little bit more chenua.
We knew better.
What, sweetheart? Can you do the yolk here?
I can feel it.
Okay.
It looks really fast.
You know, I have never been able to do that. I'm wondering if it's because of...
They're because of the tray.
It's because they're small? I don't know.
It's the tray.
And the thing is, I don't have a heart. The question that Natasha had is, okay, now, her egg already looks, it already looks larger, and it's spinning, and it has all of these bubbles that are on it, okay? And her question was, why was her egg spinning, right? And you were saying, Chinua, you were saying, hold your egg up. You were saying, why is your egg floating now? And at first it went down to the bottom, right? It's, okay, the acid, well, why don't you guys tell me what you think it might be? Exactly. The bubbles are holding it up. They have air and they're making it buoyant. You have another idea? About this. Where do you think some of these bubbles might be coming from, though? Exactly. And we know the shell does have something in it to make the bubbles come, and it has calcium, okay? Now, we know, you tasted that vinegar, how did it taste?
It tasted really sour.
It tasted sour, and it was because it had that acetic acid in it, okay? And that acetic acid is interacting with the calcium, and it is producing bubbles of carbon dioxide, and those bubbles are making it buoyant, just like what you said, and they're doing something. Yes, as already said, what are they doing to the shell is coming off, because what's it do to the calcium? Very carefully with your finger. Not going to give. Okay. Here, you wipe your finger off. Okay. I want you very gently to feel the shell. Does it feel hard like it did before? How does it feel?
It feels gooey.
Oh,
I know why.
Exactly. Why? Exactly. Exactly.
Well, the bubble in your hand, it's going to be rocky.
Exactly. Did you hear what she said? The shell is dissolving, so it's almost feeling slimy because all the calcium is dissolving. It's going to dissolve right down to the membrane. What, dear?
Like, is it because of the bubble?
Exactly, exactly, because there's a chemical reaction going on between the calcium and the acid, and that chemical reaction is actually dissolving the shell. Now, our scientific question was, can we balance a raw egg? Look
yes.
at him, look at that. I can see those bubbles, yours is rolling the bubble. Oh, there's a feather and you can pretty amazing. Okay, now, our scientific question was, can we balance an egg? Okay, now this is an egg that we've had for quite a while in our vinegar. Now, it's raw. What's gonna happen? Da-da-da. First, it looks a little bigger than a normal egg, doesn't it? And it's because the membrane is porous, right? So some of the liquid went in this porous membrane. Now feel it very gently. How's it feel?
Ew.
feels like cheese.
Have you ever felt cheese before?
It feels melted.
It feels like there's, it feels like a layer that has this really light liquid. It feels like, like a basketball,
like a basketball?
Those squeezing balls.
Yeah, it does. Okay, is it soft or hard?
Soft.
Okay, now feel, okay, feel the difference. And there's a difference in color too. The color came over time.
So it looks like mold.
Yeah. Isn't that weird? It was exactly like this before.
Is it the shell that's making it the shell though?
The shell is gone. Just like
Yes, it's gone.
It's totally dissolved. And you know what this is, you guys? You know what all that's left? You are right. All that's left is that membrane. Membrane's holding it together. Now, back to that $20 you were going to make, because you were going to say to your parents, can I really balance a raw egg? And they're going to say, no, you're not. No, you can't. You're going to say, oh, yes, I can. Okay, let's try it, you guys.
Why
is it going to make it back? Because he's not a guy. I think it's just going to just have a here. Okay, now look, you guys. Now, is this going to bounce?
Yes.
Look at that. It bounced just like a ball. Look at that. Isn't that weird? Now, if I hold it really high, it still will break. Don't hold it up very high. Let's try it. Very gently. Isn't that weird? Look at it bounce. Look at that. Just like a ball. All right, look at that. Isn't that weird? Now, don't drop it really high. Try it again. Isn't that neat?
Whoa.
Look at that bounce.
That's awesome. That's
whoa, look at that. I love that. Try it. Oops. It's like a water balloon.
But it sort of has, isn't that neat? But like you have more of a balloon that you put water in, so it makes it squishy.
That is so neat. Okay, yeah, look at that. Now, yours is going to do the same thing. We're not sure how long it's going to take. Now let's feel. I still feel some hard shell, do you? Okay. Let's put everybody's egg up on that top shelf. And we'll see how long it takes until you can bounce your very own egg and you can take this home. And this egg here has been in this vinegar for about 4 months. 4 months. So you can save it for a long time. All right. Yes. Okay. I'm going to get you a pen and you can put your name on. Okay. So we know that calcium is a wonderful thing. We know that calcium protects the egg, but we can dissolve it off. Okay. All right. We're done. Now, let's look at differences in eggs, okay? First, we have a great big egg. Look at this, you guys. What kind of egg is this?
Ostrich.
Ostrich egg, okay. Now, here we have a picture of an ostrich. If this is such a big egg, how big do you think the bird is?
Big.
Do you guys know?
Yes.
Let's see. Now, this is Buffy's egg. You know that Buffy, what Buffy weigh about? Four or five pounds. This great big egg here, this bird can weigh as much as Miss Glenna.
Absolutely.
Or even more.
Is it getting taller than Miss Glenna?
Oh yeah. These ostriches, and these guys are tough. I mean, they are big birds, okay?
That baby egg can
weigh more
than Miss Glenna?
No. Not the egg. We mean actually the bird.
To its bird.
Yeah. Oh. I mean, the birds, these guys are really huge.
They're way taller.
If you look at this picture, they can be 6 feet tall. People can really ride those. People can put saddles on these. Come on over, Miss Candace. People can put saddles on these and ride these ostriches. And they're fast. They can run Is it, it's between 20 and 40?
20.
Yeah. Wow. That's pretty fast. That's what I can learn. Okay. Now, okay. Great big egg. Say it.
Great big egg.
Medium egg?
Medium egg.
Would you like to see a little bit of the egg? Okay. All right. Okay. Okay, look at this robin egg. That's a teeny, tiny, tiny, tiny egg. Now, this egg weighs probably less than 1 ounce.
Oh, wow.
And the bird itself, a robin, a baby robin, is just so teeny tiny when it hatches. I mean, tiny, tiny, tiny. And they fluff out with their feathers, but they're almost all still all egg. Okay, you guys. Now, would you like to see a little petite robin feather? Are you ready? Okay, now, let's see.
Close your eyes, and keep them closed.
Open your eyes. Look at that tiny feather. That is so tiny. Okay, put out your hand, you guys.
Tail feathers.
Yeah, yeah, it is. It is a tail feather. Isn't that neat? It's so tiny, you can't even feel it. Isn't that neat? It feels so soft. Okay, little bitty feather, little bitty egg. Now, okay, let's see. Let's get us a medium feather. This is actually from Buffy. It's the same color as Buffy, isn't it? Okay.
Buffy's
okay. Put out your hands, you guys. Now the difference with this one, okay. Feather, what do we use feathers for most? It is waterproof.
Pens.
Right here would be the oil gland. You pull your beak right along, just like that. Try it. Let's see if it is what
essence. Pens.
My scientist pens. Essence is going to see, is it, will it really waterproof? Natasha's testing it out.
It's
waterproof.
It's dry.
It's waterproof.
Yeah.
It would run right off. Okay, now. Okay, I'm gonna take, okay. You guys, now what are they? They're used for writing. What else are they used for?
Dusting feathers.
Pillows. Now, think about it, you guys. Would you like to use this for it to lay on for feathers? Thanks,
yeah.
Little bitty one. However, would you want to lay on this one? Yeah, chicken feathers do not make very good. Here, sweetheart, chicken feathers don't make very good pillows. We'll be talking about that 1 second. Okay, one observation, a scientific observation, is our eggs are now at the stage where they're floating. Are there more bubbles on them? Look, hers is turning.
Mine is also.
It's turning on its own?
Yeah.
That's pretty amazing. Okay. Let's finish this up, and then we're going to take a look and see what. You guys, you want to see a great big feather, you guys?
Yes.
Close your eyes, keep them closed. All right, open your eyes. Da, da, da.
I like the lamb now.
These are very big feathers, okay?
I want that for my can-can.
These are can-can feathers?
Da,
da, da, da, da.
Oh, yeah. Thank you, they put it on their shoulders. My mom did that.
These are, isn't it amazing that such beautiful feathers come from such...
You can put them on your shoes.
Okay, Natasha said, from what? Ugly birds.
They're not ugly, they're cute.
They are cute. They're part of nature. They're part of nature, but they're not very cute. However, stand up, Natasha. Okay, you guys, ostrich bodies are great. She's gonna be the can. Put this on. Okay, okay, she's gonna be a mother ostrich for us. Okay.
She's gonna be my baby. I wanna be taking my baby.
Wait, where's the baby?
Her essence.
Okay, all right.
Cause she has her hair.
Okay, all right, now, wait. Okay, there's her tail. Okay, all right. Da, da, da. Is she going to lay an egg? Essence, check it out. Essence here. She's going to lay an egg. There she goes. There's the egg. Woo! Now, make it hatch, Essence.
Comes in too hard.
There it goes.
You killed my baby.
Okay. Now, did you know that they grow even larger than her? It's pretty amazing. You're so cute. Okay, all right. Thank you, dear. Now, what I wanted you guys, the reason why I was showing you the difference in this, okay, all the structure, you guys, okay, the structure of the feathers is the same, right?
Yes.
Okay? you have a shaft, and then you have this nice fibrous part in the fringe, okay? Now, all three of these, for our ostrich, for chickens, and for robins, okay? Now, the thing that's really similar about this, I want you guys to look at this shell, okay? This is a shell that broke, all right? Pass that around.
A membrane.
Did you see? She found a membrane on the inside.
Here.
Yeah, you can pull it out. She found that membrane. Here. Isn't that neat? Now, our essence, try it, you guys. Hear that sound? It's like glass. Okay. So, what? So we said this, the shell is made out of what?
Calcium.
Okay, what are our teeth made out of?
Calcium.
I want you guys to feel your bones.
Calcium.
Okay, right here, our bones are calcium. Go like this on your head. What is it? Calcium. Okay. All right. Close your eyes and keep them closed. Open your eyes.
Whoa.
Isn't that beautiful? This is a conch shell. Okay, all right. Are you ready? Are you ready?
Broken.
All right. That would really work. Now, this grows in the ocean. Okay. What is this? Listen to the sound, you guys. It has that same glass sound.
It sounds like plastic.
Well, it does. That doesn't sound like plastic, does it? It sounds like glass. Okay. You guys, that calcium, what do you think they get calcium? Actually, you know, Miss Glenda is right. There's calcium in seaweed. But actually calcium is dissolved in the ocean. That water is this incredible, incredible material that dissolves all kinds of things. And it's from the soil. You're right. From the soil that's the whole basis of the ocean. Now, okay, so we know that calcium is a building block. Almost everything that's really hard, even that claw essence, even the claw sienna that we accidentally stuck that into you, the basis of most things that are really hard in nature is calcium from living things. Close your eyes and keep them closed. Open your eyes.
Is that real algae?
When I went to Louisiana, yes, I don't usually do this because you guys know I love nature, but I thought this was too wonderful. This guy's whole set of teeth. Let's see, I forgot. I think there are. They're 82.
Yes, that's 82. She knows how
these work. She does. That means, I want you guys to feel this guy's teeth. This is a real alligator. And I don't usually do this at all. But I went out in the swamp, and when I saw this guy's teeth, I said,
did you find it or buy it?
I bought it.
Isn't he wonderful?
Woo!
Miss Heather.
And I will show.
Miss Heather.
82 teeth. Okay, listen to the sound of your own teeth, okay? What's this guy's teeth made out of?
Calcium.
What's his jawbone made out of? All the same thing. And where do we get all the calcium from our body?
Milk.
Okay, now, what is the cow eat?
Grass.
What does the grass grow from?
From seeds
from the soil. And remember from our globe, what is the soil made out of? It's the earth itself, and it has the element of calcium in it. So every single thing that we need comes from the earth, and that's because we are all made out of the earth. That's what I'm trying to tell you guys, why your soil is so important, that the calcium that we need comes from the soil. Every single thing that we need comes from the soil.
Again.